Are you looking to smash your opponents at the next standard event, poison your foes in Pauper, or empty libraries in Eternal formats? No matter what way you prefer to vanquish the foul, you'll find the tools you need at channelfireball.com. We've got great prices on singles, boosters, sealed boxes, sleeves, and anything else you need to take home the win at your next PTQ or at your kitchen table. Don't get lost in a labyrinth of online shopping. Just try channelfireball.com.
Much love. Shout out to all our open-minded viewers here at channelfireball.com. TWoo here, bringing you a standard mono blue aggro deck. So it's been a while since I've been in on standard as we have explored the deep depth of modern card pool, but got to come back to standard from time to time, and what better way to do it than a mono blue aggro deck that is fun, budget, and competitive. So really the trifecta with this deck. Written about this deck and played with this deck before the printing of Cloud Form, but Cloud Form as a card really helps us out a lot, as it is a 3-mana 2/2 flyer, but the most important thing about it is the cost. The blue-blue cost makes Thassa, God of the Seas, something that we can count on, and Thassa is extremely powerful. Also fuels Master of Waves, so this is starting to get the feel of that old mono blue standard devotion deck. However, we also have an affinity feel and a Ninja Bear Delver feel, as this deck is very fast and can draw a lot of cards. So I'll show you what's going on with this deck. 20 lands in the main, 4 Darksteel Citadel and a Nykthos. Nykthos is important at generating mana to bestow Hypnotic Siren. So Hypnotic Siren is our late game and our early game. Very strong card. We have 8 blue 1-drops to start the game. Hypnotic Siren, Triton Shorestalker, or Ornithopter. So we have 12 creatures. And if we have 2 attacking on turn 2, we have Military Intelligence, which will draw us a card every turn for the game. But Intelligence is surprisingly good late in the game as well. So this flow of cards gives us more gas and gives us more devotion to power up our Thassa and our Master of Waves. So we have the Darksteel Citadel, the Ornithopter, and the Springleaf Drum, which gives us our second element of this deck, which is in Soul Artifact. 5/5 for 2 mana is insane, and it just is freebie wins all the time with this deck. So this deck has some really fast starts and versatile starts, as you can attack with a 5/5 on turn 2 or draw extra cards on turn 2. Then we have Omen Speaker, which I like as the Scry, just a 1/3. I tried Frostwalker, but it just traded with everything, so I'm still on Omen Speaker. So that's our 0, 1, 2, 3 is Clouds. Cloud Form Thassa, have the one Hall of Triumph in the deck as well, just to boost some of our small guys. It doesn't boost Cloud Form or Ornithopter, so it's not at its strength here, but it's still pretty good with Master of Waves, keeping all our elementals alive even if Master dies. Speaking of Master of Waves, this thing is just huge still. Still can get removed, but still can just not get removed and take over the game. Last card in the deck is Support, and that's Bident of Thassa. Whenever a creature hits them, we draw a card, and it's got a few abilities. It has blue-blue, and that's basically the main deck. I'm building it super aggro and proactive. I don't have any interaction in the main besides just creatures and stealing creatures, which is a decent amount to be honest, but if you're into playing some counters or some bounce or something in the main, you could do that too. Take a look at our options from the board. I always like to have another land in the board. There's just times where you want one, especially if our game plan is to bestow Hypnotic Siren. Tricks, we've got counters and Stubborn Denial, counters and Disdainful Stroke and Negate. I've got different kinds of removal and Voyage's End for bounce, Singing Bellstrike to keep something tapped, Reality Shift to swap something for a 2/2, Icy Blast to tap down the opponent's team with Ferocious. Hall of Triumph is more ways to boost our creatures and protect our Master of Waves. Daring Thief inspired combo with Springleaf Drum, trade a Triton Shorestalker for a Siege Rhino, and then Bident of Thassa is a nice one against control decks, as if they're depending on sweepers, just that one Triton Shorestalker can rebuild us. So that's basically the deck. We get to the matches. It's really sleek and runs well and is competitive and is budget and fun. So again, I recommend this deck for standard quite a bit. I like modern and its depth, but this deck has pulled me back to standard for this week. So let me know what you think in the comments. I know a lot of people are into mono blue strategies. So let me know what you think is different or could be improved. However, this 75, especially this 60, is pretty aggro and good in the main. So I think this is a good starting point. So peace out. Let's get the matches. Bam.